Everyone, welcome to Knowledge Graph. My name is Neetu Charasya and this is set 2 of the series The Vocabulary from the Hindu. So yeah, let's begin. Before we start, this is the set number, that is, this is the second video in this series. This will be the word and here is the sentence which has this particular word. This is the headline which contains this sentence and this is the category of the news. So if you're interested to go through this article, just go into the Google, type this headline, give the comma Hindu and you'll get the article. Let's begin. First word is endured. Endured means a cause which makes you love or like someone or something. This word has the word dear. So it'll be easy for us to remember that it is a cause to be loved or liked. Sentence says, his welfare schemes and his low-cost housing program had endeared him to the masses. That means whatever schemes and housing program he brought, that was the reason that made the masses love him or like him. Alright. Next word is ruthlessly. Ruthlessly means without pity or compassion for others. That means when you're not bothered about someone else, when you're not concerned about someone else. Compassion means when you're concerned about someone else's suffering or misfortune. So without compassion means when someone is not even bothered about someone else's suffering, is not sympathetic about that person, is called ruthlessly. Sentences, while doing so, he acquired a reputation as a ruthlessly efficient administrator. So whatever action this person was doing, because of those actions, he acquired a reputation as a very ruthless person, a person who's not bothered about someone else, a person who's not sympathetic about someone else. Headline was Sri Lanka to elect new president on Saturday is the same headline which contained the first word as well. Category. Third word is spruce. Now see, spruce means, if it is used as a noun, it means tall evergreen trees are called as spruce when it is used as a noun. But in case if it is used as a verb or an adjective, it means clean, neat and tidy. Neat and tidy, something that is very elegant, is known as spruce. Okay. Sentence, a cleaner capital city of Colombo with spruced up buildings, that means neat and tidy buildings, paved walkways, became a symbol of Mr. Gotabaya's efficiency. Headline, Sri Lanka to elect new president, it is the same headline as the previous two categories. This next word is dissent. Dissent in simple words means disagree, a disagreement. When you disagree from someone in whether it's in opinion, that means when your opinion varies from someone else's, is called dissent. So next time when you want to use the word disagreement, instead of that, use the word dissent so that, you know, you can learn a new word like that. So for example, two members disagreed from others in the member. You can, instead of that, you can say two members dissented from other members. This is how you learn a new word. Next word is culminated. Culminated basically means when something reaches to a very highest point, a climax of something, to a conclusion. It can also mean resulted. Sentence, his downside was attacking media personnel and crushing dissent means crushing all the disagreement or all the varied opinion under his brother's presidency, which culminated, which resulted in Sri Lanka being subject to UN Human Rights Council resolution. This is the same headline as the previous three and the category. Next word is dreaded. Dreaded means something that causes fear or terror, something that makes you frightened or that makes you terrified, is called dreaded. Sentence, the dreaded white van, that means the white van which seemed to be causing fear or terror, was blamed on the disappearance of media personnel during Rajapaksa's presidency. It is the same headline and the category. Next. Oh, this is another headline. Guys, did you notice something? This, up till number 5, you had the same headline. That means we learnt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 new words in just one article. This is how an article reading or a newspaper reading helps in improving our vocabulary. Moving on. Number 6 is lobbying. Lobbying means when you try to influence someone else on a particular issue. That is, when you're trying to influence a particular person regarding a particular issue, that's called lobbying. This word is basically used in political sentences. A legislator means someone who makes laws. So when you're trying to influence a legislator on a particular issue, it's called lobbying, though it can be used in general sentences also, but mostly you will find this word with some kind of political sentences. Sentence. The ban on funding comes into effect a year later than originally proposed after lobbying by European Union member states. After lobbying means after the European Union member state influenced people who were involved in that issue. Headline, EU bank to cease funding fossil fuel projects by end of 2021. This was the category. Next word is unanimously. Unanimously means without any objection. That means when there is no opposition. It is based on agreement. When all the people agree on a particular thing, that is called unanimously. That means fully in agreement is called unanimously. Sentence, the EIB's decision, EIB stand for European Investment Bank's decision, was expected coming after EU finance minister, EU stands for European Union, last week unanimously backed the phasing out of funding of gas, oil and coal project to help combat climate changes. That means the UN finance minister had no objections, or he agreed upon this funding of these particular things. Headline is the same and the category. Next word is block. Please note this block is different from BLOCK, whereas this block, BLOCK, means kind of a piece of a marble, or you can use it as a block of flats like that. But this block means when a group of people, whether those people are from different countries or from different political parties, when they come together for a particular goal and they form an alliance, that's called block. So block in simple word means alliance. Another interesting word is coalition. So next time when you're trying to use this word alliance, think of this word called block and coalition. Sentence, a decision on fossil fuel funding was planned already last month but was postponed due to division within the block. It was postponed because there was a division within the alliance as some countries wanted gas funding to continue. Headline is the same and the category. Next word is sustainable. Something that can be maintained at a certain level is called sustainable. That means maintained at a certain rate is called sustainable. For example, you use this word as sustainable development, sustainable economic growth, or sustainable agricultural program. So the programs which can be maintained at a certain level and which is very helpful is called sustainable. Sentence, the EIB, European Investment Bank, the biggest multilateral lender in the world, has ambitious goal on sustainable finance, means has a goal of a finance which can be maintained on a certain rate or on a certain level. It's the same headline and the category. Again guys, see, in one single article we learned so many words. Next is detained. See, detained in general, it can mean keeping someone from proceeding by holding them back, like not letting them do that particular thing. But in most cases, this word basically means official custody, taking into official custody. Detained means taking into official custody. Abrogation in simple words means deletion. That means putting an end to a particular thing is known as abrogation. Bifurcation means a division of anything into two parts is known as bifurcation. Sentence, former Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Mehbooba Mufti was detained, that means she was taken into custody in the early hours of August 5 when the centre announced abrogation, when the centre announced a deletion of provision of Article 370, besides bifurcation, division into two parts of the state into union territories of Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir. This was the headline and this was the category. Next word is plenary. Plenary means fully attended. That means a meeting or a session which is fully attended by everyone who is required to be present for that particular meeting. Note, for business or for political aspects, plenary always is included with the word meeting or session. You'll always find this word plenary meeting or plenary session. Sentence, addressing the plenary sessions, that means all the members who were required to present for the sessions were present, of the 11th BRICS summit at the Iconic, and there were rest of the sentence which didn't write. BRICS stands for Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa. This was the headline and this was the category. Next word is insolvency. The state of being insolvent. Insolvent means when you're unable to pay your debt. Suppose if you have taken money or you have taken loan for your business and if you're not able to pay that, that is called insolvent. So being in that particular state is known as insolvency. This word is basically used for businesses. So in Hindi, insolvency basically means diwala. When your business fails and you're not able to pay for it, and you're not able to pay your loans and debts, that call insolvency. What is liquidation? Liquidation basically means, suppose if you have a business and that business fails or it's not working, so what you do, you start selling a part of your businesses. You know, you start selling your part of your businesses in order to close your business. That's called liquidation. Sentence, it will provide a generic framework for insolvency when your business is in loss, and liquidation, that means when you want to sell your businesses, proceeding of systematically important financial service providers other than banks. This was the headline and this was the category. Next word is interim. Interim means a temporary or a transitional period between two events. That means suppose if a particular event is taking between two events, that's called an interim situation. All right. That means a temporary situation. Exigency. Exigency means an urgent need or demand. Depending on the sentence, enactment has two meanings. When it is included in terms of law, it means the process of passing a legislation, means passing a law. And it has another meaning, is to act or to perform. Enact. Enact means to act or to perform something. Sentence. The special framework provided under section 227 of the code for financial service providers, essentially aimed at serving as an interim mechanism, is serving as a temporary mechanism to deal with an exigency, that means whatever demand is there, the urgent demand, pending introduction of a full-fledged enactment. Full-fledged enactment means to pass the laws or whatever is required to act upon to deal with the financial resolutions of banks. This was the headline, this was the category. Next word is inherent. Inherent means something which is inbuilt, or you can say something that is inborn. Something that naturally occurs. For example, an inherent capability of a human being. That's something that is inborn to a human being. That's called inherent. Something that exists naturally. Next word is vulnerable. It's a very common word. Vulnerable means when you're exposed to the possibility of being attacked or harmed. Now, this can be in any sense, whether in sense of health or technology or anything. For example, if your immune system is weak, you will be vulnerable to diseases. For example, if your security system in your phone or your computer is weak, you will be vulnerable to hacking. So you will be exposed to the possibility of being attacked. Sentence, an inherent design flaw means a design which is inbuilt, makes mobile app that work with Bluetooth low energy devices vulnerable, that means exposed to hacking. This was the headline, this was the category. Next word is resolved. Resolved means when you're firmly determined. So it basically means determined, but when you're very much determined to do something, then the word you can use is resolved. So next time when you're trying to use the word determined, try recalling the word resolved. Next word is intensify. It's a very normal word, which means become or make more intense. What do you mean by intense? Intense can be in any sense, whether in terms of force, strength, in terms of a strong feeling, or strong opinion, it can be anything. So intensify is to make something more intense. Sentence, during the 21st round of talks, both sides resolved, both sides were formally determined to intensify, is that means to make it more intense, and advance the dialogue for an early settlement of the dispute according to the official statement issued by both sides after the talk. This was the headline, this was the category. Next word is unprecedented. Unprecedented means something which has never been done or known before. Something which has been done for the first time. Precedent basically means something which has already been done in the past or something which is experienced. So unprecedented means something which is not experienced and something which is new. Sentence, the Falcon rocket blasted in the morning sky, marking the unprecedented. That means something which was not done before. Fourth flight of a booster for SpaceX. This was the headline, this was the category. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope this set has also helped you with your vocabulary, like the first one. If you haven't gone through that, please go through that as well. You'll find the link in the description box. This is Neil Shorse signing off. I'll meet you in the next video with some more helpful content. Till then, take care. Keep learning. Bye-bye.